What up, y'all? Two Heady here, coming at you with a banger of a story today. Today we're talking about the time how this kid broke into our apartment. This is going to be a long video, might even be a two-parter. So get your bowls ready, get your pen, your dabs, and let's get into this. So, the background of this story was me, my buddy Noel, and a couple of our other friends that we used to go and party with. And this group of friends, we had two other kids that partied like every other day. Like, they were just party animals, and they just had a bunch of people on Snapchat, so they always knew where the function was. And on this fateful day, me and my buddy Noel were like, bro, like, let's hit them up, see what they're doing. We hit them up, and they're like, yo, yeah, there's a function, but it's like an hour away if y'all want to, like, go with us. So we're like, all right, bet, yeah, that sounds good. My buddy's like, yeah, I'll take my car, we can just drive there. So we drive over to their house, we get in, we dap them up, we're like, yo, what's good? They got a bowl going, smoking the bong. We're like, all right, bet, this is gonna be a good time. And we're all talking, we're like, all right, what time is it? And they're like, well, we actually have a few different functions we can hit, all in like the same little area if y'all are down. We're like, yeah, for sure, dude, that sounds fire. So the first function was just this little, like, campfire, bonfire, in, like, the middle of the woods next to a cul-de-sac. And we send it there. We stop at a gas station. We get some Fireball nips. And we got, like, a 12-pack or a 24-pack, I believe. Don't ask me how we got it. I was in the car. But we get on our way to this little area. And we pull into the cul-de-sac. We're like, where the fuck is this? We start driving down, and probably a quarter mile down this little road, we see just a bunch of fucking cars parked on the side. We're like, oh, this is probably it. So we pull into our parking spot, and we start seeing kids funneling into the woods. We grab our nips, and we head out. And we get over there, and it's just a bunch of kids standing around a bonfire. Not even a bunch, it's like 40 kids standing around a bonfire. So we stay there a little bit. These kids are like got on an ox and rapping with like a karaoke machine over it. Fucking whack. So we get a little tipsy, and at this point the boys determined me the DD. And I was like, oh, okay, like I thought I was gonna be able to have a good night tonight, but you know, whatever. They're like, yeah, you're max like two drinks. I was like, fuck. So I take my first nip right away, and I was like, all right, I'll just sit on this for a little bit because this party was trash. And we get over there, and like kids start arguing and shit, and we're like, yeah, this shit's gonna get busted soon, let's dip out. So we dip out. There was no chicks there, so we dipped out. The homies wanted to like go fuck some chick or some shit, so we slide over to the next party. And this one was a little further away. It was like, it was more in the country, I'd say. It wasn't in the city. And we pull up, and it is this nice, like, 2-3-story crib with, like, 10 acres of property. Their driveway was, like, a half a mile long through a big-ass field. We pull up, and we see at least 50 cars pulled up there already. We're like, oh, this shit's gonna be a banger. We get up, we pull in, and we walk down into the basement. The whole basement's unfinished. It literally just looks like a crack den. We're like, all right, this is chill, I guess. There's kids smoking downstairs and shit. So that's what we do. Me and the boys, we roll up at the function. We start handing shit out. We're like, yo, like, what up? How is everybody? We didn't know fucking anybody there. So we're just trying to catch the vibe, see what everyone's doing. And like, none of these kids want to fucking interact with us. They're all like, man, I'm good, I don't want to smoke that, all smoking their own little fucking blunts. We're like, all right, fuck you guys. We go upstairs, and this is where like everyone was getting fucking turned, was upstairs. We walk up, and it's just this beautiful living room and kitchen. We're like, all right, word. We go out to the deck and start sparking up. We tried to spark up inside. We asked a few people, and they're like, yeah, you can do it. We start lighting in. A chick freaked out. She's like, are you guys fucking dumb? What are you doing? Smoking inside? Like, yeah, my bad, bro. So we go out to the deck, and this is when things start getting rowdy. As soon as we go out, everyone starts flooding out to the deck. And now everyone's playing beer pong and shit. And I remember Sheck West fucking, what was that song? Mo Bamba comes on, and everyone starts raging. There's this kid that's just faded. He climbs up onto the roof of the deck and jumps off into the back crowd, like as the beat drops on Mo Bamba. And we see this kid fall through everyone's fucking arms, just splat right on his back. Music cuts. Everyone's just like, what just happened? And he shoots up. He's like, yeah, let's keep going. His fingers fucked. Like, he's definitely fucked up, but he's too drunk to even notice. And at this point, we're like, yeah, this shit is not going how we wanted. Like, let's see where else we can go. So we head back inside. But first, we hit a fat lick on their fridge. We take some drinks, we take some fucking food and snacks, and we get back on the road. And at this point, we're like, all right, it's getting late. It's like 12:31. Let's see if there's any other functions going on. My buddy hits up one of these kids, and they're like, yeah, there's still one going on right now. It's like in this big field. It's a huge ass bonfire. It's like 150-200 kids here right now. We're like, all right, bet, we'll pull through. So I'm driving up, and we drive up. It's another little like cul-de-sac roundabout. We pull in, and as soon as we're pulling in, there's a group of kids just kicking and stomping this kid on the ground. We like roll down our windows, and this kid comes running to us. He just jumps in the back seat of our whip. We're like, bro, what the fuck are you doing? Who are you? What's going on? It's like, dude, they're beating the shit out of me. Like, help me, help me. And this was the kid. This was A&W, the kid that was getting jumped. And we had no idea what's going on. We're a little turned too. So we're like, yeah, bro, you're chill. We're like, what the fuck are you guys doing? We're like, are you friends with him? He's in your car. Get him out of here. We're going to kick the shit out of him. He's like, dude, they just jumped me, took my off-white shoes, took my fucking Gucci belt or some shit like that. I'm like, oh, bro, we're so sorry. They're just like, get the fuck out of here, get the fuck out of here. So we go down to this little pull off at the end of the road, and we're like, okay, bro, what happened? He just explains it. He's like, yeah, I don't know, like, I was about to leave and these kids started fucking jumping me as soon as I left. Like, all right, like, do you have a place to go? Where are you going? He's like, bring me home, bring me back there. We're like, we're not bringing you back there, broski. We end up calling one of the kids that like he had in his phone that I guess used to be his friend. He's like, brah, nah, this kid is fucked. Like, do not interact with him. You can bring him to come grab his shit, but he's not staying with us. We're like, bro, who is he? We don't even want to like go on with this kid. All right, y'all, we'll pause this story right here. Let's take a fat little bowl together. Cheers, everybody. Oh, almost forgot to tell you, I'm smoking on some of that Scrooge from Scorched Earth. Absolute gas. Alright, so pretty much we bring this kid back to the party. We kind of just leave him. We're like, bro, we have no idea where you are. We're like an hour and a half away from where our homies are, like where our crib is at. We don't want to be involved in this. So we just brought him back to the party. One of the homies walked him over, made sure he didn't get fucked up anymore. Got his shoes back and shit. We're like, just go somewhere, dude. Like, call a ride, call your parents. We don't care. And this is where we met Aunt W. So at this point, me and the homies were still in high school. We hadn't gotten our own apartment yet or anything. And fast forward probably 4 or 5 months, maybe four, like 4 months. We graduate, and me and my homie Noel go and get an apartment together. And this apartment we ended up sharing with a few other people. It was a 4-bedroom, I believe. And we had 5 people staying in there. One of the homies was crashing on the couch for a bit. But that's besides the point. So we go there. It was a big college town, and a bunch of like block parties and shit happened like every weekend until winter hit. So we pull up to one of these block parties. There's hella people here. Like, the whole block is just filled with people. Cops are getting kids out of the road, like just trying to control everything. We're out here having a great old time. Me, the boys, there's 5, we're like, I don't know, we're like 5 to 8 deep. I forgot how many people were actually there, but we all are just token mobbing around, having a good time. Got some brewskis and shit, and we end up meeting this kid there again, and we're like, oh, like, what's up, dude? We barely even remember him, but he remembers all of us by name. Like, what the fuck? Like, okay, I guess you do know us. Like, what's good? And, like, we dap him up. He ends up following us around, though. He was not with anyone or anything. He follows us around the whole time we're at the party. Me and my girlfriend end up dipping back to the crib. And we smoke, pretty much lay in bed, and watch some Netflix and shit. All the other boys are still at the party at this point. we have another homie come back. My homie Noel comes back. It's like, yeah, I'm fucking tired, bro. Party's dying down a bit. Like, I'm just go to bed. Like, text the other homies just to lock up when they come in. We're like, all right, yeah, word. So I text the group. I'm like, yo, boys, like, whoever's last in, make sure you lock the door and keep it locked. Both of us are home, so no one has a key in. Just knock. So they pull up. We get the last group of the boys to pull up. And they're like, yeah, we're fucking faded, bro. We're about to just eat some food and fucking knock out. They come in. I end up locking the door. And we're all just thinking it was going to be a good night. One of our homies is sleeping in the living room on the couch. One of our homies is in his room with another one sleeping on his floor. And then me and my homie Noel are upstairs. So it gets to, like, I don't know, 3:30 in the morning. Hold up. Let's take another rip, y'all. A little blinky for you. We're smoking on some Mole Face from Oasis Refinery and the buds from Aquanox up in Maine. Okay, I end up waking up pretty late in the morning with my girl. She has to leave, so her mom's there to pick her up. And I walk downstairs, and A&W is sitting on our couch where our homie was fucking sleeping, knocked out. I'm just like, dude, how did this kid get in here? Like, we don't even fucking know him. We met him once, and how is he in our crib? So the homie that's sleeping on the couch that was right under, like, our front windows that is right on the street. So he's like, so this is what happened. I'm sleeping and I feel like something hit my foot. I just thought it was Noel's dog, so I didn't really think much of it. Then I feel the full screen of the window push in and fall on the floor. And I look, and this kid is climbing in through our fucking window and just fell and hit the floor right in front of me. He crawled right over me, and it's like 3:30 in the morning. We're just like, bro, who, like, even showed you how to get in here? Like, who showed you where we live? He's like, I asked one of the people that you were with, like, if I could crash with you guys, and he said, yeah. And I was just coming back from the party. Like, bro, we've all been back for like 2.5 hours, 3 hours. Like, we were all asleep when you came into the house. It's like, I was knocking on the door and everything, but no one answered. So I just thought I would sneak in through the window. It's like, bro, you literally took our whole window off the fucking sill. Like, what is wrong with you? You just broke into our crib without telling us. Like, we don't know you. We don't have your phone number. We don't know who the fuck you are. And we were all arguing, me and the boys, like, going to the kitchen, try to figure out what to do. We're like, do we kick him out now? Like, he's kind of already in here. So he ends up wanting to go to another party. We're like, all right, I guess. He asked our buddy, give him a fucking ride home, because he said he was kicked out of his house and he has, like, money and some clothes over there. So my buddy Jay goes and picks him up, brings him to his crib. And he has, like, a full off-white outfit with a belt and everything, bag, comes back to the party. We're like, all right, word. We head out. We go to the little liquor store. We all grab some something to drink. He's like, yo, like, we should throw one at our crib and, like, get a bunch of shit. Like, all right, I guess so. He grabs, like, 4 30-packs, throws them on the counter. I grab one for my girl. And at this point, Happy Dad was just coming out. So all the boys grabbed a case. And he's like, yo, like, can anyone pay for this? I don't have much money. Like, we should all split it since we're all going to be drinking it. Like, bro, we all have our own thing. He just kept insisting. And I ended up having to fucking cave. And I told him to put back. He wasn't for it. None of the boys were helping me out. He ended up, like, fucking putting his shit with mine. I was like, bro, what are you doing? I guess. So I spent, like, fucking $60 on this shit. And I didn't drink any of it. He got, like, Michelob Ultra and fucking what was it, Bush Apple fucking disgusting, dude. But besides the point, so we end up going to this party, and this kid just smashes all these beers himself, takes them all to the face. Well, not all of them, most of them. And he's like trying to get with a bunch of these chicks. Like, he ended up making a fool out of himself. Like, he was being just so belligerently drunk, it wasn't even funny. And we were at the point like, bro, you can't fucking be here. You need to leave. You are fucking with everyone. You're making everyone upset. And he starts freaking out. He disappears. And last that we heard of him, like, he was back at his parents' crib. But, dude, this guy was the most fucking whack person I have ever met. He breaks into our apartment and then chills with us and insists on us doing all this shit for him. But I hope y'all enjoyed. I'll see y'all in the next video. Make sure you like, subscribe.